There's a lot of confusion about some of our common forestry terminology, so I'm going to take us through some of these common terms and provide just a super basic definition for what they are. Number one, forester. A forester is a professional whose job it is to manage and to care for forests. Forestry is what we practice. How do we manage forests, these living systems, for a variety of different objectives, from the protection of biodiversity to renewable resources? The textbook definition of silviculture is the art and the science of tending the forest. Silviculture can mean a lot of different things, but the most powerful tool that we have at our disposal to practice silviculture is the cutting of trees. Forest management is the practice of silviculture implemented on the ground, managing that forest, again, for a variety of different objectives, to deal with a variety of different situations that might be going on in the forest, and to steer the forest in different directions. Forest stewardship is a much more holistic term. So that describes everything that we do to care for forests. At times that might mean managing them, cutting trees, doing stuff like that. At other times it might be doing stuff like monitoring for invasive species, controlling non-native invasive plants, maintaining roads and trails and making sure they're not eroding, painting our boundaries. Forest stewardship encompasses forest management, but there's also a lot of different stuff that goes into it. A lot of times I hear people talk about a forestry management plan. No such thing. There is a forest management plan. This is a document that takes stock of where a forest is at, usually using data to tell us certain things about the condition of the forest. And that also charts a path forward. So it says, this is what we're gonna do in the forest going forward. A forest management plan often divides forests into stands. A stand is just a portion of the forest that's similar enough that we manage it as a unit. We're differentiated by different species of trees, different ages of trees, maybe different management history. A few important terms to be aware of that you're gonna see in that forest management plan are composition. The composition of a forest is the species of trees that are there. Structure. The structure of a forest is the way those species of trees are arranged. So the different ages of trees, the different sizes of trees. Basal area is a measure of tree density. So forests with a high basal area, pretty crowded with trees. Forests with a low basal area, relatively low density of trees. One of the most insidious terms that I hear a lot of is the term selective cut. The most important thing to know about a selective cut is that this term is essentially meaningless. As far as I can tell, a selective cut describes any forest management that's not a clear cut, but historically selective cut has also been a euphemism for high grading. High grading is the practice of basically going to the forest, cutting all the most valuable trees, which are often usually the healthiest trees, and leaving the less valuable, less healthy trees behind. It's just an awful way to manage a forest. While the aesthetic impact might be less than a clear cut, there's a pretty strong argument to be made that the ecological impact, the impact on that forest, is actually greater, because you've managed the forest to be less healthy, weeding around the least healthy trees, and you haven't created enough light to regenerate a new generation of trees that has a chance to be healthy. In our forestry vernacular, a clear cut describes an area where you cut all the trees or almost all the trees that's greater than 10 acres in size. If it's between 2 acres and 10 acres in size, we call that a patch cut. If it's less than 2 acres in size, we call that a group. Commercial forest management is when we manage the forest and we're selling wood from that forest management project. It's commercial because it pays for itself and even generates income to the landowner. You might also hear commercial forest management described as a timber sale. I'm trying not to use the term timber sale just because I feel like it does a disservice to the broad range of different things that we're doing as we practice forest management. We're not just selling timber, we're managing for biodiversity, we're managing for wildlife habitat, we're managing for climate resilience and all this other stuff. Instead, I call it a forest management project. The last term I want to talk about is logging. I want to draw a distinction between a logger going into a forest and cutting indiscriminately, and when we manage a forest for a variety of different goals and objectives in a way that's thoughtful and intentional. That former term, logging, I used to describe unsupervised logging. That latter term, forest management, I used to describe more intentional, thoughtful management. That said, foresters are completely dependent upon loggers to manage the forest. In most cases, we're not the ones who are out there actually cutting those trees. We are marking the trees to be cut, we're supervising that work, but we're completely reliant upon loggers to actually cut those trees down, to actually enact the change that we want to see in the forest on the ground. The way that we talk about things matters, and I think it's really important that we're a little more precise with the language we use around forests and forestry.